Chapter 10, Living Creatures, Exploring Their Characteristics, Short Notes and Summary from Grade 6, Subject Sceince, Book Curiosity. Introduction, Living versus Non-Living. Everything around us is either living or non-living. Living beings, like animals, plants and humans, have special features. They can move, grow, breathe, respond to changes, reproduce and eventually die. In contrast, non-living things such as pencils or rocks do not show these characteristics. Everyday examples. Think about a pigeon in the window versus a pencil on your desk. The pigeon shows many signs of life, movement, growth, response, etc., while the pencil does not. 10.1. What sets the living apart from the non-living? Characteristics of living things. Living beings share a set of common traits, movement. Even though not all living things move from place to place, plants may not change location but still exhibit movement, such as opening flowers. There is some form of movement. Growth. Living beings increase in size and complexity. For example, a child grows taller and a seed grows into a full plant. Nutrition. They need food to get energy and to help their bodies grow. Respiration. All living things breathe in air or absorb oxygen to turn food into energy. Excretion. They remove waste from their bodies, whether it be through sweat, urine or other means. Response to stimuli. Living beings react when something happens around them, for instance, moving away from something hot. Reproduction. They have the ability to produce new life so the species can continue. Death. Eventually, all living beings will cease their life processes. How to differentiate? Compare any object with yourself. You grow, your body requires food, you breathe and respond to the environment. A car, for instance, may move but does not grow, breathe or reproduce, so it is non-living. 10.2 Essential Conditions for Germination of a Seed. Germination meaning. Germination is the process by which a seed sprouts to form a young plant. Key requirements. Water. Water softens the seed coat and activates enzymes needed for growth. Air. Seeds take in oxygen from the spaces in the soil, which is essential for respiration. Light or dark conditions. While many seeds like beans germinate in the dark, some seeds require light. The right intensity of light or its absence help in sprouting and further growth. Practical experiments. For example, if you plant bean seeds in different pots. Pot A. No water and direct sunlight usually means no germination. Pot B. Excess water might harm the seed even though sunlight is present. Pot C, moist soil in the dark, will show how important both moisture and oxygen are. Pot D, moist soil with direct sunlight often creates the best conditions for germination. Observing these differences helps you understand why each condition matters. 10.3 Growth and movement in plants. Plant growth. Direction matters. Roots. Always grow downwards because they need to absorb water and nutrients from the soil. Shoots grow upwards, reaching for sunlight, which is crucial for the process of photosynthesis. Plant movements. Plants do not change locations, but they still move. Phototropism. Shoots bend toward light. Gravitropism. Roots grow in the direction of gravitational pull downwards. Gnostic movements. Some plants, like the touch-me-not, fold their leaves when touched. Experiments with plants. Activities such as placing a seedling in different positions, upright, inverted, or with light coming from one direction, help demonstrate these growth patterns. Know a scientist, Jagadish Chandra Bose, 1858-1937. Who was he? Jagadish Chandra Bose was a pioneering Indian scientist who conducted exciting experiments on plants. His contributions. Crescograph. He invented a special device called a crescograph to measure how fast plants grow. Plant response. Bose showed that plants can sense and react to external stimuli such as light, heat, and gravity, proving that plants are much more active than they seem. Why it matters? His work helps us appreciate that even plants, though stationary in one place, are living and responsive creatures. 10.4 Life cycle of a plant. Stages of a plant's life. First, seed. It all begins with a tiny seed. Second, germination. Under the right conditions, the seed swells, breaks open, and a radical, young root and plumule, young shoot start to appear. Third, seedling. The young plant grows into a seedling with small leaves and a developing stem. Fourth, growth and maturation. The plant grows larger, develops more leaves, and eventually produces flowers. Fifth, flowering. The plant blooms and flowers appear. Sixth, fruit, seed production. Flowers turn into fruits like pods that contain seeds. Seventh, cycle continues. The seeds will eventually germinate to form new plants, continuing the cycle. Observation activity. Students are encouraged to plant a bean seed and observe the changes over a few months to see this life cycle in action. 10.5 Life cycle of animals. General concept. Just like plants, animals go through different stages in their life. They start as a young baby or larva, grow into adults, and eventually reproduce to give rise to the next generation. Significance. Life cycles help ensure that the species continues to exist even after individual animals die. 10.5.1 Life cycle of a mosquito. Stages of a mosquito's life. First, egg, laid on or near water. Second, larva, hatch from eggs and live in water. They come to the surface to breathe. Third, pupa, a transitional non-feeding stage where the larva transforms. Fourth, adult, the mature mosquito emerges, briefly rests on the water, and then flies away. Important note, because mosquito larvae need oxygen, stagnant water becomes a breeding place, which is why it is important to eliminate standing water around homes. 10.5.2 Life cycle of a frog. Stages of a frog's life. First, egg, spawn. The female lays jelly-like clusters of eggs in water. Second, embryo. The eggs begin their development. Third, tadpole. Hatch from the eggs and live in water, breathing through gills and possessing a tail. Fourth, froglet. Tadpoles start growing legs and the tail begins to shrink as lungs develop. Fifth, adult frog. The froglet loses its tail completely and becomes capable of living on both land and water. Metamorphosis. This transformation from a water-bound tadpole to a land-capable frog is an exciting example of metamorphosis. Summary, key points. Characteristics of living things. Living organisms show movement, growth, respiration, nutrition, excretion, response to stimuli, reproduction, and ultimately die. Germination. A seed needs the right amount of water, air, and proper light or dark conditions to germinate. In germination, roots grow downward and shoots grow upward. Plant life cycle. It starts from a seed, continues through germination, seedling stage, maturation, flowering, fruit seed production, and then repeats. Animal life cycle. Animals undergo several stages from a young one, egg, larva, tadpole, to an adult, ensuring the continuation of the species through reproduction. Mosquito and frog life cycles. Mosquito, egg, larva, pupa, adult, frog, egg, spawn, tadpole, froglet, adult, frog. Jagadish Chandra Bose contribution. He demonstrated that plants are responsive beings, further deepening our understanding of plant growth and movement. So friends, we have completed short notes and summary from chapter 10, Living Creatures Exploring Their Characteristics. We have already studied the question answers of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.